What is up, guys? Gimmer, the video game scientist from VG Bootcamp here, and today we got a new video. We're going to be talking about the new ledge options, the changes to the ledge in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Before we get into that, I just want to make an announcement real quick. I have a new Discord, the Gimmer Discord, and I also have an application for you to be a researcher in the lab. And the idea really is to help me lab the game because only so much one person can do. All it requires is that you actually know what you're doing, you understand the game enough that I can trust you the information you give me. It'll help me work on some stuff, and it will also help some projects we're working on in the future. Now let's get into this video. Sorry for making you wait so long. This is a real video with a real analysis about the new ledge options. I've been studying this a lot. I actually have a video coming out eventually about the new air dodge. I have a new video coming out about the new parry mechanic, and I have a video coming out about the new dash dancing and movement. It might take a couple weeks, but I've been working on these videos since the game was announced. Now, like I said before, this video is focusing solely on the ledge, and Smash Ultimate's ledge is very similar to Smash 4's ledge, but there are some key differences that are really important and are going to shape up the metagame and actually make ledge trapping not as viable. You know, edge guarding is already really good in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, so it's good that they nerfed ledge trapping because it would just make being off stage really, really, really frustrating. So I'm glad they made the ledge options not as trash. So let's get into it. So in Smash 4, when you got hit, you could not grab a ledge for 55 frames. It looks like in Smash Ultimate, that window has shrunk, so you can grab the ledge faster after being hit. So if you get jabbed next to the ledge, you won't necessarily drop really, really far and miss it. Two framing is still in the game. So two framing is where if you get hit while you're grabbing the ledge, the first two frames, you have no invincibility. So even if you have a recovery option that is invincible leading up to grabbing the ledge, those first two frames of grabbing it, you can be hit. Now in Smash 4, magnet hands kind of grab the ledge from far away, and ultimately it looks like they're a little closer, which makes that two frame more viable. Now, when you grab the ledge, there are five things that can happen. One, you do a regular get up. Two, a get up attack. Three, a ledge jump. Four, a ledge roll. And five, let go of the edge into something, whether it's air dodge, double jump air dodge onto the stage, or jump aerial, or just, you know, whatever. But if you're grabbing the ledge and you do nothing and your opponent grabs it, you go into what's called a ledge trump animation. If they grab it right while you're grabbing it, this leads to follow-ups because the ledge trump animation itself is 27 or 28 frames. Now, in Smash 4, every character had a set ledge trump animation, some low, some high. In Ultimate, you can DI the ledge trump. You can DI away to avoid follow-up, but it puts you in a riskier situation because of the new air dodge, or you can DI into the stage. But if they read that you're gonna ledge DI onto the stage, they can hit you with anything they want, basically. This option doesn't make ledge trumping obsolete. It just makes it a little bit rougher, but I'm pretty sure some characters are still gonna be able to hit you no matter how you DI the ledge trump. Regular getup is pretty much exactly the same in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. So you're pretty much invincible the whole time and you have one frame where you can be hit. And if you hold shield, that means they have a one frame punish window, or they can go for grab since it requires you to buffer a roll or spot dodge to avoid it. The thing is, because of the new parry mechanic, getting up and holding shield won't get you an accidental power shield into some sort of punish. What you have to do is you have to get up and then tap shield and hope they mess up their punish. But if they read you're gonna do that, they can just smack you in the face. This is kind of why I really love the new parry mechanic, because it makes it so cheap, like non-thought strategies that rely on your opponent messing up are much harder to get away with in this game. Something really interesting, in Smash Ultimate, you can now buffer moves out of ledge jump. In Smash 4, if you did a ledge jump, you had to time your move perfectly. The game literally wouldn't read inputs while you were jumping. Like, I tested this out. If you jump and you try to input Ryu, True, Shoryuken, you can't make it come out immediately. It's not possible because the game literally can't see the inputs that you're putting in. This is really good because it makes getting off the ledge a little bit easier, because in Smash 4, ledge jumping was the best option, but you had to time stuff perfectly. And if you mistime it, your character just jumped and did nothing. Just like Smash 4, though, you have invincibility up to frame 12. On frame 13, you can start doing a B move or an attack, just like Smash 4. And then on frame 15, you can do an air dodge. A lot of people actually didn't know that about Smash 4, but there was actually a two-frame delay on air dodges, making punishing the ledge jump option really easy in Smash 4. And now it's pretty easy in Ultimate, but because you can buffer an air dodge out of it, it makes the punch a little harder. And because it's a directional air dodge, you're not just flying up in the air into nothingness. You can actually air dodge on stage, and if your opponent mistimes a really strong attack, you get a free punish. Now here's a really, really interesting change. Ledge roll is now four frames faster. Now you might think that doesn't really matter, but there was a really, really annoying ledge trap in Smash 4. What happens is the player faces the ledge and shields. If a get-up attack happens, they grab. If a regular get-up happens, they react, and they grab. And then if a ledge roll happens and they go past them, they let go of shield, they dash back into a dash grab. And you're probably thinking, well, what is 4 frames going to make difference? Well, shield drop is now also 4 frames longer, which means you have 8 less frames to react to ledge roll. And guess what? Those 8 frames are actually enough to make it nearly impossible to react to that option select. I could be off, I could be wrong, but I did the math and I think it gets rid of that option select. And that is the one ledge trap that was really, really annoying to deal with, because if you did a ledge jump, it really didn't put your opponent in a bad position. That being said, with a new directional air dodge, it might not make a difference because ledge jump into air dodge is probably really hard to react to too. But I think it's interesting that subtle change, like it shows you that Sakurai and the rest of the developers were really thinking about everything. They were really watching how we, the competitive scene, played the game. And I'm really excited for it because edge guarding is so good in this game that if they kept ledge trapping at the same levels of Smash 4, being put off stage would be really annoying, like worst than Melee. So I'm really excited for it. I don't know much about get up attack. The buzz told me that it's like invincible on like frame 1 of the get up attack, or like frame 1 frame before it. So like you can't straight out beat it. You either trade with it or you get hit by it. But I haven't found footage to verify it. So I'm not sure, but that might be possible, but don't take it as gospel. Anyways, that is all the changes to the ledge in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'm really excited to see how it affects competitive play. I think it's cool, and I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, consider giving it a like. If you like my channel, consider subscribing. And if you really like my channel, consider turning on notifications. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I gotta go. I'm really busy, so it's back to the lab with me. I'll see you guys next time. Uh-oh. Start!
Back to the lab again. Oh no, back to the lab again. We messed up. Back to the lab again. Not again. Back to the lab again. Back to the lab again. Oh no, back to the lab again. We messed up. Back to the lab again. Not again. Back to the lab again.